the Holy Spirit. We're going to talk about Baptists. What they believe, what they don't believe, really doesn't matter. We're going to talk about what the Bible says. But we're going to answer some of the Baptist preachers that I heard on the radio that are misleading the people. Let's read Luke. Let's see, chapter 24, verse 49. And now I will send the Holy Spirit, just as my Father promised, but stay here in the city until the Holy Spirit comes. There's a teaching that once you accept the message, once you accept the message of Christ and you become born again automatically, you receive the Holy Spirit. And here the scripture, read it in any translation, it says, the Holy and now I will send the Holy Spirit, just as my Father promised, but stay here in the city until, who's he talking to? He's talking to the apostles that went out two by two and they healed and they cast out demons. They were believers. They were washed in the blood. They were born again, if you will, because they had the message. Jesus says to Peter, blessed are you because the Father has revealed this to you. You have communications with the Father. The Holy Spirit has not yet come though. There's two, it's different events. And now I will send the Holy Spirit just as my Father promised, but stay here in the city until the Holy Spirit comes and fills you with the power of heaven. He's talking to Peter, to John, to Andrew, to all these guys who've been with him for 3 years. They have received the message, obviously, but they have not yet received the power. Jesus says, do not go anywhere without the Holy Spirit. They have not had the power of the Holy Spirit. Don't tell me once you receive the message and you say the born again prayer, you automatically have the power of the Holy Spirit. You don't. You don't. You don't. You don't. You don't. Look what it says here. That there's a separate event. Let's see what the Bible says. Don't turn it off yet. I'm just going to give you scriptures. Chapter 16 of Mark. Look what it says here. Verse 15. And he told them, go into all the world and preach the good news to everyone. Anyone. Not just the apostles. This is not just for the apostles. Not just for their day. But it says anyone who believes it and is baptized will be saved. But these miracles, signs, will accompany those who believe. So when you believe, it's not enough to believe. There will, signs will follow. They will cast out demons in my name and they will speak in new languages. They will be able to handle snakes with safety. And if they drink any poison, if, not they should, but if they drink poison, it will not hurt them. They will be able to place their hands on the sick and they will be healed. Jesus' words, okay? Jesus' words. Let's go to John chapter 7, verse 38. Anyone who believes in me, anyone, it's not just for the apostles, these miracles, the prophesying, the gifts of the Holy Spirit himself, the tongues, the healing, it's not just for the apostles. If you keep listening, I will show you all the scriptures that doesn't say it was just the apostles. And it wasn't just for those days, because it says anyone who believes, not just the apostles, anyone who believes in me, not me, but Jesus, may come and drink from this, for the scriptures declare, river of living water will flow from him, from his, 38, his heart. When he said living water, he was speaking of the Spirit, who would be given to everyone believing in him, not just the apostles. But the Spirit had not yet been given. So everyone who believes will get the Spirit if they want to. But it wasn't just an apostle day, because they had not yet come. So when Jesus breathed on them and said, receive the Spirit, guess what? It was just a metaphor. It was a sign. It was something Jesus was trying to show them. But they did not have it yet, because he said, I have not yet gone to the Father. Follow the scriptures. Because Jesus had not yet entered into his glory. Verse 39, in any translation of John, verse 7, verse 39, it says, read it again. When he said the living water, he was speaking of the Spirit who would be given to everyone believing in him, but Spirit had not yet been given because Jesus had not yet entered into his glory. This is talking about the Holy Spirit will come after Jesus entered his glory. Let's keep going. I got more scriptures. Chapter 14 of John. Look what it says in verse 17. He is the Holy Spirit who leads into all truth. The world cannot receive him. Because it's not talking about salvation or the message. Anybody can receive the message. It is, but the world cannot receive him because it isn't looking for him and doesn't recognize him. So if you Baptist people not looking for the Holy Spirit, the power of the Holy Spirit, you're not going to get it. But you know him because he lives with you now. And later, he will live in you later, not when you breathe, but when he is glorified. He later, now and later, will be in you. No, I will not abandon you as orphans. I will come to you. I will come back to you. The Holy Spirit is Jesus. That's a different issue. 16, chapter 16. It says, chapter 16, verse 7. But in fact, it is best for you that I go away, because if I don't, the advocate won't come. If I do not go away, then I will send, if I do go away, then I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will convict the world of its sin. It's talking about a specific person, the Holy Spirit, because he can convict. It's not talking about people who just hear the message, and I will show you. Read these scriptures for yourself in all 10 whatever translations you can get your hand on. Read it in all of them. Pray to the Holy Spirit. Reveal it to me, because if this is true, you can't just ignore it. You can't just comfort yourself away and say, oh, no big deal. Acts chapter 1. Do not leave Jerusalem, verse 4, until the Father sends the gift he promised. As I told you before, John baptized with water, but in just a few days, you will be baptized in the Holy Spirit. This is not just receiving the message. Apostles already had the message, but they had not yet been baptized in the Holy Spirit. And it's not just for the apostles. It says for everybody. Verse 8, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses, telling people about me everywhere, in Jerusalem, through Judea, in Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. Chapter 2 of Acts, verse 17. In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit. In the last days, I will pour out my spirit upon all people, not just the apostles. And it's not just in their day, in the last day, up to today. Listen to this. Not just the apostles, but your sons and your daughters. There's no female apostles, you know, in the 12. Obviously, they're daughters will prophesy. What is that? How can you accept this prophecy and only choose some versions of it? Let me explain what I mean. How can you choose? Oh, this is for the apostles in the later days. But then it says, your young men will see visions and your old men will dream dreams. In those days, I will pour out my spirit even on my servant, men and women alike. Men and women alike. And they will prophesy. Not just speak in tongues, but they will prophesy. Why are you ignoring this gift of the Holy Spirit that is given to everyone? Look what it says in verse 21. But everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. How can you say that anybody can call on the name of the Lord and be saved? You can take that promise, but the promise that's in the same prophecy that you will receive the Holy Spirit, you don't take the power of the Holy Spirit. To prophesy, to see visions. Okay, that doesn't apply to me, but to call on the name of the Lord and be saved, that does apply to me. How can the verse 17, 18 not apply, but verse 21, how do you just pick and choose? If it says you will receive the Spirit, you will receive the Spirit. This is in the Bible. I'm not making this up. Your young men will see visions. Hey, nothing is impossible for God. Young men will see visions. Old men, but how come they're not seeing it? Because they have been deceived to believe that's only for the apostles. You can't see visions. You can't prophesy. Word of Jesus never says don't. Jesus never warns not to. He says you will receive the Spirit. You will receive. And it's not just a message. You can't ignore promise 21, verse 21. You accept that one. Call on the name. We'll call on the name. It's not. What is that just for the apostles? Verse 21. Is that just for the apostles? But everyone who calls on the name of the Lord be saved? No. It's for you right now. But how come verse 17 is not for you right now? See, your teachers have been misleading you. You need to ask the Holy Spirit what you should believe, not the teachers that have been lying to you. Acts chapter 3. Let's skip that. Let's skip chapter 5. chapter 6 of Acts. And so, brothers, select 7 men are well respected and full of the Spirit, other than the apostles. Other than the apostles, there were 7 men full of the Spirit and wisdom. So right there, it's not just for the apostles. Look what it says in chapter 7 of Acts, verse 55. But Stephen, full of the Holy Spirit, gazed steadily into heaven. And full of the Holy Spirit, without the Holy Spirit, he would not be able to see this. And into heaven, and he saw the glory of God, and he saw Jesus standing in the place of honor at the right hand. He was willing to die. Are you willing to die right now? Or maybe you denied the Holy Spirit. Maybe you have said no to the Holy Spirit. Then of course you can't die. You can't even say no to sin. You can't even say no to food. You can't even go on a diet or on a fast. Why? Because you don't have the power of the Holy Spirit. You cannot do anything with your strength. You need the strength of the Holy Spirit. That's why Stephen, he was being stoned to death. But yet he looked up into heaven. He didn't even feel the stones. Why? Because he was full of the Holy Spirit. If you're not full of the Holy Spirit, you're not going to be able to die for Christ. You're not going to be able to say no to the Antichrist and reject 666. You're not full of the Holy Spirit. You need, this is not an option. You have to have the Holy Spirit in order to get saved. It's not an option. Chapter 8, verse 6. Crowds listened intently to Philip, because they were eager to hear his message and see the miracle signs he did. Many evil spirits were cast out, screaming, and they left their victims. And many had been paralyzed, who had been paralyzed, lame, were healed. So there was great joy in the city. Samaria received Philip's message. But now the people believed Philip's message of good news concerning the kingdom of God. They believed, but yet they did not have the power of the Holy Spirit. Kingdom of God, the name of this, verse 12. As a result, many men and women were baptized. They received a message and they were baptized. They were born again. They were born of this and then of that. But they had not yet received power. How do you know? Chapter 8, verse 13. Then Simon, a man were baptized. Simon, the sorcerer, was baptized too. The Simon himself believed and was baptized. Verse 13 of chapter 8. He began following Philip wherever he went. And he was amazed at the signs and great miracles Philip performed. He did not receive the Holy Spirit. He was baptized. He received the message. He changed. He was a sorcerer. He was freed from the power of the devil. And he was following Philip. Verse 14. When the apostles of Jerusalem heard about the people of Samaria had accepted God's message, this confirms they accepted the message. They sent Peter and John. Verse 15. As soon as they arrived, they prayed for those believers who had received the message, who were born again, who were baptized in water. These are not people that have not received the message. They completely received the message, the believers in Samaria. But look what happened when Peter came and John came. They prayed for these believers. They were not the ones that were not believers yet. To receive the Holy Spirit. They prayed for them to, read it in any translation. For them to receive the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit had not yet come upon them. So they received the message. They were Christians. They loved Jesus and all this. They had not yet received the power of the Holy Spirit. Verse 16. You cannot ignore this. The Holy Spirit had not yet come upon any of them. For they had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. They were converted, received the message, loved Jesus. They were baptized in water. You can't convince an unbeliever to be baptized in water. But yet they accepted the message. They were baptized. Then Peter, verse 17. Then Peter and John laid their hands upon these believers. And they received the Holy Spirit. What happened? Oh, nothing. They just received the message. No, they received the message earlier. They were baptized in water earlier. But now when they laid their hands, they received the Holy Spirit. When Simon saw the Spirit was given, when the apostle laid their hands on the people, he offered them money. Simon saw a difference, a physical something he saw in these, not in the apostles, not just for the apostles, but physically he saw a change. Physically he saw a difference. He saw it, the God, the Holy Spirit. He saw the tongues, he saw the prophecies, he saw the gifts of the Holy Spirit. And when the Holy Spirit comes, he comes, and you can see it. If you did not have this difference in your life, think about it. Because Simon saw a difference, and he offered money for the same ability. There was a difference. Something. It wasn't just being baptized in water and accepting the Lord Jesus Christ and not automatically have the Holy Spirit. I'm sorry, the gift of the Holy Spirit, the power of the Holy Spirit came on the Samaritan people. They were not apostles. And he can come on you today. It's in the Bible. I'm not preaching Mormonism or some other book. I'm telling you the Bible. Pray and let the Holy Spirit reveal to you.